morning, students. Today we shall continue with the previous video, that is in unit 18, lesson number 18, heredity. We shall continue with this new topic, structure of DNA and replication of DNA and mutation. So in the last video we have learned the structure of chromosome, what is the structure, where it is located, the position of gene, DNA, all that we have learnt. And also we learnt about the karyotype, what is karyotype, what is ideogram, all that we learnt. Just you recollect what are the topics that we covered. Structure of chromosomes, different types of chromosomes based on centromere, based on the position of centromere, and based on the different types, autosomes, autosomes, based on the functions. We learnt about different types we learnt, and also we learnt the sex determination in human beings we learnt. So today in this class we shall continue with that. And here in this video we are going to learn a very interesting topic, and that topic is what is the structure of DNA. So already you know what is DNA, is deoxyribonucleic acid. What is the structure of DNA, how it is getting replicated, all that we are going to learn. So let's just learn. So first we shall learn about the structure of DNA. What is DNA? So what is this DNA? DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid. Deoxyribonucleic acid is DNA. Here this DNA structure is very, very important. It is because of this DNA the characters are transferred from one generation to another generation. Already I have told you, so chromosome, it is nothing but highly coiled chromosome, is a thin thread like structure which is made up of DNA, and genes are nothing but segments of DNA. So they carry the genetic information from one generation to another. So they help in transferring the characters from the parents to offspring. So today what all the characters that we possess, it is the characters that we have received from our parents. It is because of these genetic units we have received the characters from our parents. So let us learn the structure of DNA. So here, so James Watson and Francis Crick, so these two eminent scientists, they were the first one to propose the structure of DNA. So DNA, it is the hereditary unit which is responsible for transfer of characters from one generation to another generation. And these two scientists were the first one to frame the structure of DNA. So they both, James Watson and Francis Crick, many proposed the model, but this model received the Nobel Prize in the year 1962. So James Watson and Francis Crick, so this model is called as Watson and Crick model. This model is called as Watson and Crick model. Here in the year 1962 they received Nobel Prize for medicine for this structure called that is Watson and Crick model. In short form we call it as Watson and Crick model. So now we shall see the structure of DNA. So DNA, it is made up of polynucleotide. It is made up of polynucleotide, and the major components of DNA, it is, the first one is the sugar molecule. sugar molecule deoxyribose sugar is present, and second one is nitrogenous base. Purines, there are two types of nitrogen base, purines and pyrimidines. Purines will have adenine and guanine, and pyrimidines will have cytosine and thymine, and the last one is phosphate group. So here there are three major components present in a DNA. The first one is sugar base. It is called as nitrogenous base. It is made up of deoxyribose sugar. DNA has three important components. The first one, it is a sugar molecule. It is nothing but deoxyribose. Here you can see the structure. So sugar molecule is nothing but deoxyribose sugar. Second one is nitrogenous base. This nitrogenous base is of two types. The first type is purines, and the second type is pyrimidines. Now, purines, there are two subtypes. Purines are adenine and guanine. Pyrimidines are cytosine and thymine. Now, always we have to remember, adenine, that is one purine will pair with one pyrimidine. Adenine will always pair with thymine, and cytosine will always pair with guanine. So these both are nitrogenous base. So the first component, the first main component in a structure of DNA is sugar. Sugar is nothing but the deoxyribose sugar, and the second component, it is nitrogenous base. So nitrogen base, there are of two types, purines. I told you nitrogenous base is of two types, purines, pyrimidines. Purines, there is adenine, guanine, and pyrimidines is cytosine and thymine. Always one purine will pair with one pyrimidine. So adenine will always pair with thymine, cytosine will always pair with the guanine. Like this, always the pairing will be like, it goes on like this. And then phosphate group, the third one is phosphate group. So third one is phosphate group. So this is the main structure of DNA. So DNA has three main important components. The first one is sugar. Sugar is nothing but the deoxyribose sugar. It is made up of deoxyribose sugar. Second one is nitrogenous base. Nitrogenous base is of two types, purines and pyrimidines. Purines, there is two types. Here you can see adenine and guanine. Pyrimidines, it is of two types, cytosine and thymine. So always you should remember, one purine will always pair with one pyrimidine. So adenine will always pair with thymine. Cytosine will always pair with guanine. So here the last third component is phosphate group. So first main component is sugar. Second one is nitrogenous base. Third one is phosphate. So these three will form the main structure of DNA. So now you shall learn, I told you DNA is a polynucleotide. So what is polynucleotide? Poly itself means many. So it is made up of many proteins. What is this polynucleotide means? Poly means many. Nucleotide means proteins. It is made up of many proteins. So first we shall see what is nucleotide. See here, nucleoside. Nucleoside means nitrogenous base with sugar. So this is a sugar molecule. Sugar with nitrogenous base, it is called as nucleoside. And this is when it is linked with the phosphate, this nucleoside with the phosphate, it is called as nucleotide. See here, so nucleoside is nothing but nitrogenous base. What are nitrogenous base? That is purines and pyrimidines are called as nitrogenous base. Nitrogenous base with sugar, and what is nucleotide? Nucleoside with phosphate. It is called as nucleotide. So now here we shall see, this is the structure of DNA. So what is DNA? So DNA is nothing but so what is DNA? Deoxyribonucleic acid. So this expansion you should learn, deoxyribonucleic acid. So here you can see the structure of DNA. So in this structure, this double helix means a spiral structure, and it runs anti-parallel. It's not parallel, it runs anti, double helix structure, it runs anti parallel. You can see the structure of DNA. It is a double helical structure, and it runs anti parallel to each other. And here in this DNA structure, you can see the nitrogenous bases. You can see, I already told you, one purine will always pair with thymine. So always adenine will always pair with thymine with two hydrogen bonds. See here, I have drawn two lines, with it will pair with two hydrogen bonds. Cytosine will always pair with guanine with three hydrogen bonds. And here similarly, cytosine will always pair with guanine with three hydrogen bonds. Adenine will always pair with thymine with two hydrogen bonds. The pairing goes like this. And here you can see, in one complete turn, there will be 10 base pairs. This is called as nitrogenous base pair. This is one pair, this is one pair. So like this, there will be 10 base pairs in one complete turn. In one complete turn, how many base pairs will be there? There will be 10 base pairs. And this is, if you see, this is 3.4 nanometer, that is 34 angstrom. 34 angstrom can also be called as, measured as 3.4 nanometer. One complete helical turn will have 10 nitrogenous base pairs, and the length will be 3.1 complete turn. It will be 34 angstrom, nothing but 3.4 nanometer. And this is called as, I told you, adenine will always pair with thymine, cytosine will always pair with guanine. So this is called as complementary. This is called as complementary base pairing. What is this called as? Complementary base pairing. Complement base pairing. That is, adenine will always pair with thymine with two hydrogen bonds. Cytosine will always pair with guanine with three hydrogen bonds. So this is the structure of DNA. So DNA, it is double helical structure here, which runs anti-parallel. They don't run parallel like this. They run anti-parallel. So they are anti-parallel to each other, and they have complementary base pairing. And each turn, there is 34 angstrom, and there will be 10 base pairs. So here you can see again, the in between they have phosphodiester bonds for the stability. So to become the chrome, to become the, for the structure of DNA to be stable, to be steady, so for the stability, there is phosphodiester bonds located. So here, see here, what are the three main components? Oh, I already told you, the three main components in the structure of DNA. The first one, it is a sugar molecule, that is the deoxyribose sugar. Second one is, what is this second one? nitrogenous bases. Adenine will always pair with thymine. Cytosine will always pair with guanine. So this is nitrogenous bases. The third one is phosphate group. You can see the structure of phosphate group. So these three will form the structure of DNA. And now, according to Chekhov's rule, there will be equal proportion, that is equal contribution of RDRs, purines and pyrimidines. Adenine will always pair with thymine and cytosine and always pairs with guanine. There will be equal contribution. The contribution or the pairing of purines is equal to the pairing of pyrimidines. What are purines and pyrimidines? They are nothing but nitrogenous bases. Nitrogenous bases is of two types. First one is purines. The second one is pyrimidines. Purines, it's of two types. Adenine, here you can see adenine, guanine. Pyrimidines is of two types. Cytosine, thymine. Adenine will always pair with thymine. Cytosine will always pair with guanine. So here you can see adenine will pair with thymine with two hydrogen bonds. Cytosine will pair with guanine with three hydrogen bonds. So you have learned the structure of DNA. What is the significance of DNA? Is this DNA so important? The entire world exists only because of this DNA. What is the significance of DNA? It is because of this DNA, the characters are carried from the parents to the children because of this DNA. So it is the genetic material through which the characters are carried from one generation to another generation. And I already told you DNA is a polynucleotide. So it is responsible for formation of proteins. And it is also responsible for all the physiological functions of an organism. For all the activities, vital, very important activities of an organism, DNA is responsible. It is the controlling center. It is very essential. So structure, you have to learn the structure of DNA as well as you have to learn the significance of DNA. So now we shall move on to the next topic, DNA replication. DNA replication. Again, this is a very important topic, DNA replication. Here, what is this DNA replication? The DNA multiplies, the replica. So, during the time of cell division, the DNA multiplies. It forms the exact copy of its own. That is called as DNA replication. The replication carries out using the complementary base pairing. Okay, so now this DNA replication, how it is carried out, we shall see. The first one is, I told you DNA, it is coiled. It is coiled structure. So during the time of replication, that is origin, we call it as a particular point. At a particular point, there is an enzyme called as helicase. So this is enzyme. This is called enzyme. What are enzymes? Enzymes are proteinaceous structure which is necessary for all the vital activities. So here, during the time of replication, the first one is origin of replication. When it is here, where it is actually taking place, that is called as origin of replication. Here this enzyme helicase is found attached to the origin, to the region where it is replicated. And the enzyme, here one enzyme is there, topoisomerase. So topoisomerase, helicase will bind with the origin of replication. And topoisomerase will help in unwinding of the DNA. Now, this DNA is coiled, it is twisted, like a coiled, like thread, how one thread and the other thread is twisted. So, when during the replication, this unwinding should take place. Unwinding means the coiled structure should be removed. So during that time, that place, here topoisomerase will help in the initiation of replication. This enzyme is there, and this coiled, see here, it is coiled, and this coiled structure, when it is separated, we call it as unwinding. What do we call? We call it as unwinding. We call it as unwinding. Unwinding means the removal of coil. Removal of coil is called as unwinding. So when the DNA is unwinded, it resembles like this structure, resembles like a fork. So it is called as replication fork. It resembles like fork. So we call it as replication fork. So how we have a fork spoon, like that the DNA will look. So it is called as replication fork. The first one is origin of replication. In the origin of replication, enzyme helicase is used to bind the origin of replication, and topoisomerase will initiate the replication. And here it will, unwinding of the replication, unwinding of the DNA will take place. And when this structure will resemble like a fork, so it is called as replication fork. Okay, now after the unwinding of this chromosome, unwinding of the DNA, there will be RNA primer. See here, there this region is called as, this region is called as RNA primer. These two, this portion, this region and this region, is will act as complementary base pairing, will act as a complementary strand. Only based on this strand, a new strand will be formed. This coiled one is separated. This strand and this strand will act as a complementary strand, and based on this complementary strand, only new strand will be formed. So for this, we need RNA primer. What is RNA primer? See here, it is a short segment of RNA, and this short segment of RNA will initiate the hydrogen, will initiate the nitrogen base pairing. So this is here, you can see the RNA primer, and here during the replication, one strand will be continuous. See here, this strand is continuous. This strand is continuous, and this strand is called as leading strand. The strand which is continuous is called as leading strand, and the one more strand which is not, see here, it is not continuous. This is not continuous, and this strand is called as lagging strand. And here we have a short fragments. So this fragments is called as Wakazagi fragments. What are Wakazagi fragments? Can be asked in 2 marks. So Wakazagi fragments are the short segments of lagging strand DNA. So by doing the replication, RNA primer will initiate the complementary base pairing. In this base pairing, one strand is completely continuous, and this strand is called as leading strand. The other strand which is not continuous, which is discontinuous, is called as lagging strand. And in this lagging strand, you can see short fragments, and that fragments, it is called as Wakazagi fragments. And this replication will be going on. At last it will end. So that is called as terminus. At last the replication will end, and this region we call it as terminus. Replication will come to an end. Then later on, this replication is responsible for the synthesis of new proteins. So main step of what is DNA replication? DNA replication can also be called as DNA duplication. Like one DNA, an exact copy of its own DNA will be formed. Multiple DNA duplication, or DNA multiplies, or it can called as DNA replication. So in this DNA replication, I told you first origin of replication, it all will take place during cell division. Origin of replication means that the exact place enzyme helicase will bind, and the second one topoisomerase enzyme will also bind with this. It will initiate the replication, and this coiled structure of DNA will separate and they look like a fork structure. So it is called as replication fork, and unwinding of this DNA takes place. And here the structure or unwinding of DNA will take place, and RNA primer will initiate the replication. And one strand here, DNA polymerase, there is one more enzyme, DNA polymerase will help in the replication, and the RNA primer will initiate the replication. One strand will be continuous called as leading strand, other strand which is discontinuous called as lagging strand. The short fragments are called as Wakasagi fragments. At the last, there will be terminus which is ended here, and it is joined together by the enzyme ligase. Now, the last topic is called as mutation. Here, mutation, it is called, what is mutation? Mutation is nothing but sudden hereditable changes taking place in the chromosome is called as mutation. Sudden hereditable change taking place is called as mutation. So, who coined this term mutation? It is first one, Hugo de Vries. Hugo de Vries in the year 1901, he was the first scientist to introduce this term mutation in this plant Oenothera lamarckiana. Oenothera lamarckiana means evening primrose, Andimandare we say in Tamil Andimandare. Oenothera lamarckiana plant, he found this mutation. What is mutation? Mutation is a sudden change, sudden hereditable change in the chromosome. It is called as mutation. Who first introduced this mutation? It is Hugo de Vries in the year 1901. He introduced this term, and where did he found this mutation? In this plant Oenothera lamarckiana. And this mutation, it is of two types. First one, chromosomal mutation. Second one is gene mutation or point mutation. I told you what is mutation? Sudden heritable change. Sudden heritable change, it is called mutation. So first, we will see the chromosomal mutation. First, you shall see the structure, chromosomal mutation. In chromosomal mutation, again there is two types. Chromosomal structure will change or change in the chromosomal number. The first one is chromosomal structure. In chromosomal structure, see for example, in chromosome structure, it is four types, that is deletion. One thing will be removed, deletion, or extra thing will be added, addition, or inversion. Inversion means this fragment will be changed to that fragment, inversion. Deletion, one pair will be removed, deletion, or extra will be formed, addition, or just translocated, inversion, or translocation. In your higher classes, you will be learning what is deletion, inversion, addition, translocation. So, chromosomal type, chromosomal mutation, the first one is structure. In a structure, so for example, in structure, something will be removed, that is deletion, extra will be added, addition, or translocated, the chromosomal number arms will be translocated, translocation and inversion will take place. The second one is euploidy. Euploidy means it refers to the change in the chromosome number. Structure is different. Chromosomal variation is mutation itself. Structure is there. Second one is chromosomal number will change. So for that is called as euploidy. It is called euploidy. Euploidy means here the entire set of chromosomes will be increased. For example, diploid. Already I have learned what is diploid. Diploid means 2n set of chromosomes. Diploid means 2n set of chromosomes. Triploidy means 3n set of chromosomes. Tetraploidy means 4n set of chromosomes. This we can see, this tetraploidy usually we can see in plants, that is in flowers and fruits. So if there is a tetraploidy mutation, means the size of the flowers and the size of the fruits will be large in size. So usually this tetraploidy is seen in plants. So euploidy means it refers to the change in the number of chromosomes. First one is diploid, second one is triploidy, third one is tetraploidy. Diploidy means here euploidy means the entire set of chromosomes is increased. So diploidy means 2n set of chromosomes, triploidy means 3n set of chromosomes, tetraploidy means 4n set of chromosomes. And next one, aneuploidy. This is also related to number of chromosomes, change in the number of chromosomes. Aneuploidy. Aneuploidy means monosomy. Here it refers to the gene. Here aneuploidy means it refers to the addition or deletion of gene. Here monosomy. So monosomy. Mono means one. So somy means it is reduced. So 2n minus 1 is monosomy. Trisomy. So tri means 3. So here 2n plus 1. 2n plus 1 is trisomy. Nullisomy. 2n minus 2. 2n minus 2. So this is about the structure of chromosome. And I already told you number. If one number is also varies, the entire individual itself will change. For example, in human beings we learned about Down syndrome. In human beings we have learned Down syndrome. So it was first proposed by this scientist Langdon. So it's called as Down syndrome in the year 1866. Here what happens? Trisomy condition is seen. Here trisomy condition is seen in the 21st chromosome. We have, so human beings, we have 23 pairs of chromosomes. The first 22 pairs of chromosomes is called as the body chromosomes. In that body chromosome, in the 21st pair of chromosome, that is in the 21st pair of chromosome, 3 XX chromosomes will be present. That is trisomy condition will be seen. So that is called as Down syndrome. Down syndrome, what is those people, those who have this extra chromosome, they will be mentally retarded. So mental retardation can be seen and all the physiological activities will be very slow. So that is called as Down syndrome. Down syndrome is seen in human beings. How, what is that condition? In the 21st chromosome, there will be extra 21st pair, there will be one extra chromosome. That is called as trisomy. And who was the first scientist to propose this? It was Langdon Down. So it is, this syndrome is named after the scientist Down. And in which year he proposed? He proposed this in this year 1866. Okay, now we shall see the next type of mutation. That is, mutation means sudden heritable change, and this mutation is broadly divided into two categories. First one is chromosomal mutation, second one is gene or point mutation. So the other name is gene or point mutation. In this gene or point mutation can be seen in the nucleotide of the chromosome. in the nucleotide of the chromosome, you can see gene or point mutation. So, okay children, so with this, we shall just recollect the topics that we covered in this video. So, first we learned what is the structure of DNA, who proposed the structure of the DNA. It is James Watson and Crick. So, it is called as Watson and Crick model of DNA. And here in this DNA structure, see here you have the three DNA structure. Here it is a part, they received the Nobel Prize in the year 1962. DNA is called as polynucleotide, and there are three main components. I already told you so many times. So, sugar molecule, nitrogenous base. Nitrogenous base is of two types, purines and pyrimidines, and then here you have phosphate group. So, you should learn these terms also. What is nucleoside? Nucleoside means nitrogenous base plus sugar is called as nucleoside. Nucleotide means nucleoside plus phosphate. So, you can see the structure of DNA. Complementary base pairing means adenine will always pair with thymine. Guanine will always pair with cytosine. Then we learned about DNA replication. So, how many enzymes are used in this DNA replication? Totally four enzymes. First enzyme helicase, topoisomerase, DNA polymerase and DNA ligase. Totally four enzymes, they play an important role in DNA replication. Mutation, two types, chromosomal mutation, second one gene or point mutation. So, with this we have come to the end of this lesson, heredity. So, I will just recollect what are the topics that we covered. Heredity, we learnt what is heredity, what is genetics, what is variation and what is Mendel's monohybrid cross, dihybrid cross in the first video. In the second video, we have learned the structure of chromosome and what are the different types of chromosomes we learnt. And in this third video, we have learnt what is the structure of DNA, the replication of DNA and what is mutation. With this, we have come to the end of this lesson. So, prepare well. Stay home, be safe. Thank you, boys.